Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to be using these Artist Loft watercolor paints. So I've been using these for a while now. I just have them laying around. So I thought, I haven't used these in a while. Let me just take a look at them again. So that's what we're going to be doing today's video. So I'm just going to like take this off. I always take this off because I think it's easier to work with. Okay, now I don't know how to take it off. Okay, there we go. What I know about these watercolors is that they are pretty chalky, but they're only $9, so it's pretty good for a watercolor palette. And this comes with 36 different colors, so that's pretty nifty. So what we're gonna do first is just swatch all these colors and see what they look like on paper. Alright, so I have my water brush pen. So I'm gonna be doing this one by one. Let's see what they look like. This one looks like a pretty muddy green kind of color. I might have put way too much water on this one, but the colors are so vibrant. Thank you. Look how vibrant that is, and I've added a whole bunch of water. Now let me see the lighter blue. Oh, this is so pretty. I love this. This is what the colors look like. There's one thing I gotta say about these is that they're super vibrant. Like, this one's not completely dry, but I didn't really pick up that much, but usually you start picking up some stuff. Oh yeah, so this one's very chalky. So I mean, you gotta be really careful with these. Like, make sure they're not rubbing against anything, or else it's gonna start like rubbing off. All right, so I did this quick little sketch. All I gotta do is just ink it and then we can start coloring. All right, so I'm gonna be using this Micron pen to ink this drawing. The only bad thing about these Artist Loft watercolor paints is that they're really chalky. They also transfer very easily and they smudge a lot once they're dried. So if that's not a big deal for you guys, I think they're okay watercolor paints. I'm sure you can find something else out there that's way better than this. But for the price and then the amount of colors that it offers, I think it's pretty good. I wouldn't use these watercolor paints for something like super serious, but like if it's to have it in the sketchbook where I'm not gonna have like another drawing on the other side and I just want a pop of color and I don't want to use my other expensive watercolor brands, I would like use this one just to add a pop of color. And I think that's pretty much it. And like for beginners who are like learning how to use watercolor paints, since the palette comes with a lot of colors, I didn't really have to do that much mixing. And the times that I did have to do mixing for like her skin, I had those little boils. So the top cover that I like ripped off at the beginning, I used that as my mixing palette and it came in pretty handy. So the texture of these paints kind of feel like actual paint. I don't know if that makes sense. Okay, so like after I let a layer dry, like on her skin, if I go back in with a lighter color after that dries, that lighter color is actually gonna be on top of the color that I already laid down that dried. I don't know if that makes sense. Kind of like acrylic paints, you lay that down, it dries, and then you put another layer on it and then you can see that top layer. That's kind of how this paint is like. So it's not like a regular watercolor. Cause with a regular watercolor, if you put a lighter color on top of a color that's already underneath there and it's darker, it's not going to show But with this paint, once that dries and then you put another layer on top of it, it's going to show. So it almost doesn't even seem like watercolor. But the few times that I've actually used these watercolor paints, I really do like them. I don't really mind the chalkiness, but I know a lot of people are like upset about that. But for me, I do kind of like the texture. The only thing I don't like is that it transfers and it smudges. But besides that, I like the texture. All right, so for the pros and cons, let's start with the pros. It comes with 36 colors. The colors are very vibrant. I got mine's at Michael's for only $5. And if you carry a coupon in, that's even cheaper than that. It does come with a brush, but that brush is pretty bad. I wouldn't use it. It comes with that little covering on top with the little boils for you to like mix colors. So that comes in very handy. All right, so now for the cons. It is chalky, it transfers, and it smudges. And also the brush that it comes with isn't very useful. And one more thing, so the color that actually goes down does fade a little bit. I'm not sure, maybe I'll try to point it out when I see it. So I see that a lot in her shirt. So the pink color that I add as her shadow does kind of fade, and the time lapse really helps with that. And then for the darker brown that I go in on her hair, it does fade into like a slightly lighter brown. And the time lapse really does help with seeing how the color just like fades into like a much lighter color. And I definitely saw that when I was doing her hair, because I had a really, really nice, rich brown color that I added to it, and then it kind of like fade into like a lighter brown color. And I was like, what the hell is this? All right, so I think this is where I start to color her shirt. And you can just see how the color just gradually just changes into like a lighter pink color. But yeah, just watch how that happens. Well, that's pretty much all I have to say about these watercolors. I hope you all had a great Christmas. Lots of presents. I'm guessing the majority of you guys got a whole bunch of art supplies. I got a whole bunch of art supplies too. I'm actually waiting for them to come in the mail. Can't wait. It's starting to feel like an addiction. I need to stop. I already have enough. Just stop. But like seriously, I'm like running out of room to actually have my art supplies. Like I gotta use these up before I order another batch or something. So for those of you who are like asking me to review markers and stuff, like it's gonna be a while. I don't wanna buy something that I'm not gonna use that often. So just hang in there for now. I made such a big mistake on the background. I wanted to add like little rose details as like just around her, and I really was not liking how it was looking. The composition was not okay at all. Oh, I also forgot to mention that these dissolve once water actually like gets on top of them. So that could be like a bad thing or something, but for me in this instance, it was a good thing. So I was able to melt away the majority of those flower buds by just adding water onto them and like scraping them off. And that's actually when they dried. And then I looked at it and I was like, I don't really like this. And so I took some water and I literally just like scrubbed it off. It didn't come off completely, but like the majority of it was like gone. It came off enough that I wouldn't be able to see like the shape of the flowers. And I was able to like go on top of it with a light blue wash of paint. But you could still see little hints of that pink color, and I think it makes a pretty cool effect. All right, so once I was done with the background, I took my Micron pen again and I started to re-ink it. And re-inking it with the paint being so chalky was a little hard because it kept clogging my pen. And so I had to like constantly just rub off the charcoal, the charcoalness from my pen. So that took me way longer than it should have. After I was done inking, I took my white pen and I added in the little details that I needed to. And this is the final result. I hope you all like this video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you all in the next video. Bye guys.